Good morning, everybody. You know what? We've got some crazy stuff going on with the weather. Now, I've seen this system that's in the Atlantic, okay? It's Invest 99L. I haven't said anything about it because it looks like it's no worries to us, okay? But I'm going to talk about that on this day, Tuesday, the 6th day of December, the Lord's blessed us with 2022. We got some snow. We got some heavy rain in places coming up, and I'm going to show you everything you need to know coming up, so don't go anywhere. I know a lot of you are saying, "Jewel, I thought hurricane season was over." Well, according to the higher ups, it is, but I'm just telling you, things are happening, people, that have never happened before. I'm not saying this has never happened before. I haven't looked it up, I haven't studied it yet. I've just looked at the system in general, and it should not be a threat to the U.S. Now, when you get up further north, say up around Long Island, moving on up into the coastal areas here, okay, the coast, just the very coastal areas over here, and up in to our friends in Canada, up in these areas here. You're going to get some wind, not necessarily from this system, but it's going to mix in with another system. And I'm going to show you this in a second, but it is going to turn into a big storm. But this particular system, which is called Invest 99L, it should go right on up and out. Now, the winds this morning in this system are 40 miles per hour. The barometric pressure is 29.56. The coordinates is 25.3 north, 54.6 west, and it's just around 1,263 miles southeast of Hamilton, Bermuda. Now, according to the National Hurricane Center, it's large, it's complex, it's a low pressure, and it's located over the central subtropical Atlantic. They say about 800 miles northeast of the northern Leeward Islands. Now, it continues to produce a broad area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and all of the environmental conditions appear conducive right now for the system to acquire some subtropical or tropical characteristics while it meanders generally northeastward during the next few days. Now, it's going to make a loop-de-loop, like a little circle, and then go on out. Now, by Friday, the low is expected to move over cooler waters and interact with the mid-latitude trough, and that's going to limit the potential of any more tropical transition after that time. Now, in 2 days, it's got a 40% chance. In 5 days, it has a 50% chance. Just to put everybody's mind at ease as of right now. Of course, anything's possible, folks, like I've stressed to you right now. So I'll keep my eyes on it, and if any changes occur, I'll let you know. But right now, you can see here it is. It's a low pressure system. And this is the TVCN model right here. Let's just click it off and click it back on. You can see it's right here, okay? Here's Bermuda over here. Here's the Virgin Islands down here. It's out in the Atlantic. Now, when I usually go by this model, this is what I consider one of the very best tracking models. It's got it going all the way up here. All of the most popular models for right now, you can see, remember I told you it was going to make a loop-de-loop? The TVCN have it making that, but when we come over here, we have another model here that is going to make it do that loop-de-loop. We'll put it down in size a little bit, and it's the AVNO model, okay? Now, all of the models that are reliable are right here, looking like it shouldn't be a threat. But this thing's going to grow in size, folks. That's why I'm saying over in these areas, another low's going to come down, and you just liable to get some nasty weather. Okay, this is the icon model, and this goes. I've got it set, it goes out 5 days, and I'm going to go to each model, okay? This is Saturday the 10th, around 7 p.m. Saturday evening, and Here it is. See how it's going to grow in size? Barometric pressure is very low, 28.17. And it does have some wind in it here. Let's just see what some of these winds are looking like. 72 mile per hour. Yeah, very strong winds out in here. We have another low here, but we got a great big high pressure here. We got another high pressure here. And it's going to show up at, you see this low. It's a little teeny little trough. It's not going to affect it much. Once again, this is the icon model. When we switch to the Euro model, see what it says. It has it in just about the very same place with no low showing up here yet. But another low is probably going to sweep up in here. But you can see it's still in the same place. We'll hop over to the GFS model for the same time period. This is Saturday the 10th around 7 p.m. That's as far as I'm going to go out 5 days on each of these models to show you. Now you can see right up in this area here, you will have some wind. It's not outrageous wind. Most of the very high, stronger winds are going to stay out in the ocean, but it is going to cause some wind up in the Canadian area. And that high pressure, you see it right here. We got another big high pressure here. And then we got that little teeny trough that's trying to squeeze in. It's not going to affect it at all. This storm should just go on up and go out as of now. But do not worry. I'll keep my eyes on it, and I'll keep everybody posted. Looking at the high temperatures for today, we got a sandwich between cold and warm, folks, of the temperatures today. My goodness gracious. I want to bring attention up in this area, North Dakota, Minnesota, portions of Montana. You guys are going to have a wind chill advisory starting tonight, lasting through tomorrow morning, and your wind chill temperature is going to be below 30 degrees Fahrenheit. Minus, cold. You understand? Please make sure you bundle up. Don't go out if you don't have to, especially in North Dakota and portions of northwestern Minnesota. It's going to be very, very, very cold. And for my friends in Canada, God bless you. Please wrap up, stay warm the best way that you can. Little chilly everywhere else, as you see, moving on down into portions of Wyoming, Idaho. You see all these chilly highs today in the 30s and 40s. Up in Maine, you should be in the upper 40s to maybe mid-40s. But then when you start to move on down a little bit, get around New Jersey, say Connecticut, you're going to be in the higher 50s. Down where I am, I just might hit 70 degrees today. And of course, Florida's still in the 80s. Of course, it's always warmer right along the Gulf Coast in the high 70s, maybe 80 degrees. Moving up into around the Dallas area, 72, looking like Oklahoma, especially northeastern Oklahoma. You should be in the 50s today. And over for my friends in California, Northern California, 52. My friends in Oregon, 50, 40s. That's what it's going to be for you, moving right on down and across. So it's a roller coaster with the temperatures, folks. Just stay warm if you're in these very cold, cold areas as best as you can. Bundle up, wear layers of clothes. Don't go out in it if you do not have to. Severe weather today where you may have tornadoes, downdraft winds, hail. Not looking like it's going to happen. But very, very heavy rainfall is going to start and be in Texas, move across Arkansas, the whole state of Tennessee. Rain, Kentucky. You can see moving up into portions of Indiana, Illinois, Ohio, West Virginia, and Piedmont to western North Carolina and western South Carolina. Looking like northern Georgia, you're going to be getting rain. Thunderstorms are possible today, but nothing severe, moving right on across into Mississippi, as you can see. And maybe over in portions of Nevada and portions of Southern California. Now, it's looking like severe weather when it comes to thunderstorms, tornadoes, hail, downdraft winds. We're going to be okay through this week, folks. Looking like we're going to be okay. But then we've got something coming up by this coming Monday, the 12th of December. It's going to start to rack up again because cold air, warm air coming up, looking like portions of Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, a little of Missouri, and just a tad of Kansas right in this area. It's up to 15% now. It may grow. I'm not saying it's going to right now. I've got to watch these systems a little bit closer, but it is going to be more severe in any way you look at it. So just keep this under your hat starting the work week that will be coming up. The good Lord blesses us with on Monday the 12th. We could have some more severe outbreak of weather. Taking a look at the watches and warnings map right now, I told you there is a wind chill advisory. Here it is, North Dakota, Montana. This light blue, you guys are going to get really, really cold with the wind chill, so wrap up. We do have some winter weather advisories. No winter storm warnings out this morning at all. Just some winter weather advisories, and some of these are going to expire pretty soon. Now, if you're in the high mountainous areas, you guys are going to get a lot of snow, and I'm not saying if you're not, you're still not going to get some, but you're not going to get as much, and I'm going to tell you all about that right now. What you see, though, down here in this dark gray areas here from Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, western Kentucky, moving on across Arkansas, and Oklahoma, and the Florida Panhandle, all these little areas here, this is stagnated air, folks. It's got caught up. It's not moving because the systems haven't moved. The jet stream's pushing it down, so that will change. But I will say, if you have any respiratory problems and problems with breathing, please consider not going out unless you have to until this lifts a little bit, because that could make it a little worse on you. Here we have the GFS NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Thank you, Levi, my friend, for letting us use this. I'm going to turn it on and tell you what's happening. Now, we have a slow-moving frontal boundary. It's going to continue to be the focus of all this active weather across the south-central portion of the country during the next couple of days. Now, the first episode of heavy rain has already been impacting areas from the interior deep south eastward into northern Georgia and portions of Tennessee as of this morning today. Already it started. Now, the moisture will be carried rapidly northeast across the interior eastern U.S. today and into New England by tonight. So get ready for it. Now, the associated rain looks like it should be more scattered in nature. However, parts of the Appalachians as well as the northern mid-Atlantic into New England will have the best chance of seeing periods of moderate rainfall later today into Wednesday as this low pressure wave forms along the front. Now, in the meantime, I talked about the jet stream a while ago. The jet stream arriving from the eastern Pacific, it's going to begin to interact with the front across the southern plains. Now, this interaction will bring a second round of heavy rain from the southern plains, the plains eastward across the lower Mississippi Valley and into the Tennessee Valley starting Wednesday. Now, portions of these regions have had above average precipitation over the past few weeks, resulting in increasingly saturated soils. Now, what's going to happen in this heavy rain? It's going to make it more saturated, and it could increase the threat of some flash flooding. So if you live in an area that's prone to flooding, if you're in these areas, please keep an eye out on what's going on around you. By Wednesday night into Thursday, a low pressure wave looks like it's going to develop over the southern high plains along the front. Now, this system looks like it's going to shift the heavy rain threat slightly northward across Oklahoma toward the Missouri-Arkansas border Wednesday night and early Thursday. And the temperatures are going to be cold enough actually to support some wintry precipitation across the central plains at this time. So we're going to have to keep our eyes on that and see what the outcome is. The overall pattern looks like the wet weather from the southern plains into the northeast. It's going to support much above average temperatures over the next few days over the central to southern plains, eastward into the east coast. Now, below average temperatures over the next few days, they're expected across areas of the west of the Rockies and across the northern plains. Looks like the greatest below average temperatures, they're expected across the northern plains, where this Arctic air is going to keep your temperatures well below average, and especially like I've just showed you from eastern Montana across the Dakotas into Minnesota. So it's going to get cold. Now, snow, there's going to also see this thread of some periods of maybe some snow accumulating over the next 2 days. But the heaviest snows over the next few days looks like they're going to be the Rockies of Colorado, northwest Montana, and northern Idaho. Now, for everybody else where I showed you a while ago, in these areas, in the areas of the mountainous ranges, some of you guys are going to get 1 to 4 inches if you're not in the very high mountain ranges. But if you are, once again, where the heavy snows are going to happen through the Rockies and Colorado and northwest Montana and northern Idaho, if you're in the higher elevations, you guys could get a foot or more of snow as this system pulls through. So that's what things are looking like, folks. Stay safe, folks. I love you all so much. I thank you for everything you do for me. And I thank you for watching and sharing my videos more than you'll ever know. And I really thank you for sticking by me and always being here with me. You are truly my YouTube family and friends, and I love you all. Hey, have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. Much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.